Hey you guys, welcome back to Southern Latitudes. I've taken a few days off and just had a lot going on the inside and healing. Hold on, I can't do two things at once. And the only time I've been outside is to get a lot of watering done. And anyhow, I have a little project going on, a little problem actually. So it may be hard to see in the daytime, but I have these lights and some of the lights are working and some aren't, certain sections. So I turn them on during the day here and my job is going to be to fix them. I'm not sure how cool that'll be for you guys to see. But I definitely got to fix this. There you go. Can you see the lights much better now against the fence? Oh, maybe you guys can't, but I can definitely see it way better. See the lights are on there? And then right here, I have a really completely dead strand. And so I need to pull that out and see where they go to. Does it go all? No, and that's the thing, is it doesn't die right where the new plug is. It dies in the middle of the strand. So anyhow, I'm going to I have to pull all this down, and I can lay it next to where I'm going to put it, but I have to somehow, you know, that looks ugly. I have three different gaps where the strands aren't working, and instead of buying new strands, I'm just going to make it work for this year by pulling the dead sections together. And just, you know, so the light, it goes from lighted section to lighted section. Sorry, did I over talk that and overword that, make it complicated? But that's what I think is the best thing to do. Hey, also, it's a boring job, right? So I thought I would take you guys along with me for it. Not to bore you, but I wanted to tell you a little story. So remember how we put the fish guts over here? Well, what happened was that some critter decided to come make a home out here in my yard and kept digging it up. And then the dogs were getting, my dog and my sister-in-law's dog, they were getting a hold of it, which is no bueno. And so, long story short, I set the trap out with a little bit of cat food, and we ended up catching a kind of young possum the next day. And so we released him up there a couple miles north of here, but he was cute. Unfortunately, we also saw what looked like a freshly dead deer in next to the road. I felt so bad. There's actually two deer that we've seen. Was that 3 days ago? Two, 3 days ago now. Just freshly killed roadside. So somebody's hitting them with their car accidentally. And very sad to see that. Anyhow, this is all I'm doing for right now. I gotta be careful where I step over here. Probably should go outside the fence. And I'm just releasing them, and then I'll pull them tight. Come on, release, and just leave these hanging here. I still have lots of weeding to do, but now for a while, especially if I get my Christmas shopping done, I will have all the time in the world to start weeding out here, which is really good. Okay, let me do this. I'll bring you back when I'm ready to string them up the right way. You're probably thinking to yourself, hold on. You're probably thinking to yourself, Robin, why didn't you check these lights before you strung them? I did, and I think some of them are kind of like on and then off, you know what I mean? So I think they were probably on when I, or I just missed it when I plugged them in, and then they went off with me untangling them and wiggling them. But I'm not 100% certain. I just know that I tried, and I thought they were all on, but they weren't. Also, one other little quick thing I wanted to say about that possum that we caught. You know, this happens every year as we start getting these cold snaps. It starts happening more and more and more where they want to start coming in because they're cold too, right? And they want to go ahead and move in like under my sheds and or into the sheds, like the big shed that we're gonna demolish here soon. They want to go inside that one because that one doesn't even have, it's got like a big gap at the top for venting. So, you know, they love to go in there. They like to hide underneath some of these beautiful bushes or up in palm trees or oak trees. So they do that. Which bud you look at? So yeah, it's just that time of year where they want to huddle in and stay warm for the winter just like we do. It's bothered me that I haven't had the Christmas tree lights on. So I got 2/3 of it. I don't know if that's, yeah, it kind of shows up. And then this middle section, the only thing I don't have is the upper section. So let me work on that. To the last little part, and then we will have fixed all the front lights and finally got that done. As you may or may not know, I started decorating before I had surgery, and then we had to kind of just stop with however it was while I got through the first like 5 days, and then they checked my stitches. Everything is going good. I got the big bulky thing off. He said start using my thumb. I don't have a lot of strength, but I can definitely use it. And I'm doing sign language tonight, so my B's aren't real good, and my M's are better today than yesterday, so I'm getting there step by step. But anyhow, back to the tree. So we have theft going on in our city. Probably been like this every year, but we definitely have people stealing other people's Christmas ornaments. And I've always done this, and I thought I would share with you guys in case you have stuff up front, because this tree was not cheap. Even though I use it as an outdoor tree, it was actually indoor tree, but it's got a lot of sparkles and stuff. I don't want that on the inside, and it's pretty flocked and stuff. But anyhow, I think it's probably about 4 years old. We bought it when the first year we decorated for the front of this side lot. So anyhow, what I do is I put a T-post in the ground first, and then I put the tree over it, like, you know, it's got all the LED wiring or just the lights in general are wired. So I slide all that component over the T-post, and then I hook slide the second section over that too. By then I'm usually clear of the T-post, and then all I have left to do is tie it to the T-post. If somebody by chance were ugly enough to come in the middle of the night, hop the fence and think they were gonna steal a beautiful outdoor tree, I have a second thing coming for them. So that's what I'm doing right now. We're going to tie it right to the T-post. This tree is not going to go anywhere. Right over left, left over right. That should do it. If they really wanted to steal it, I suppose they could, but that's at least a really good deterrent from those who try just looking for easy targets. So it's all tied in and about a foot or so in the ground. All right, you guys, I have finished up all the light once and for all. And I came here to get a red solo cup. So we have given away 6 sets of peanut butter trees and miracle fruits. And I have the 7th lady should be here soon, or either that she forgot about me. And tomorrow is 8. And then I got a contact number 9. And then I might have enough for one more. Maybe. We'll see. But so far we're doing good on still giving away miracle fruit trees and peanut butter trees. And I don't think you could put it down in the comments below, but I think we're all out of the peanut butter trees. I'm not sure about miracle fruits, but anyhow, it looks like we're gonna be real close to giving away all the babies. So I don't know where the lady is, but I'm gonna go ahead and grab a couple of these babies and just set them on the fence for her. And then I gotta go make dinner and get ready for sign language. I'm signing a cantata on the 19th, I believe it is. Anyhow, let's see if we can find just another peanut butter tree. There we go. So that's like 2 or 3 miracle fruits and a peanut butter tree. Okay, you guys, well, that's it for me today. I didn't do too much. In fact, I got a rather late start, but that's all right. I walked this morning. It was very enjoyable, and just kind of, you know, dilly-dallied around the house, doing little chores, inside chores, cleaning and stuff. And then next on my list was to get these lights done. And I'm pretty happy. You know, some of them were, I don't think I shared this earlier, but as I played with the wire, they were turning on, turning off. So anyhow, I must have a short in one of them, but that'll do for this year. And we got enough to string around the whole fence here. And then after Christmas, I'll buy, you know, like, I think it takes maybe 6 boxes. I'll buy about 6 more boxes of lights. We'll go back to white if I can find them. And the tree is finally lit, and the angel's actually lit, but you can't see her till actually it's completely dark. And the deer, I didn't get to mention, but this deer didn't work when we plugged it in the front. So I said, okay, she'll just be for show over here during the day in the side lot. the little sections that weren't working just kind of got strung up like a rope or lasso, and then the parts that work continue on, and nobody would be the wiser in the darkness. So you guys, thank you for joining me today. I hope it wasn't exciting, but much needed job got done, and it was really bothering me to have on, off, on, off, on, off. So anyhow, thank you for watching. Take care, God bless, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.